We as an administration have made a decision led by the president that we're gonna tackle every facet of systemic racism that we can while we're here.
Anything that you wanna tell us about news tonight? Do you know anything that's gonna make news tonight that we should be aware of?
I'm not sure. I don't wanna get ahead of the president, but I think that—
Yes, you do, come on.
No. You know, this is my first time in 21 years that I actually have a boss. So, you know, I'm not, you know, this is not Friday, the movie. I'm not going to get fired on my day off. We're not doing any of that. So I'm not going to get ahead of the president. But what I will tell you is I think that people will be maybe surprised by how matter of fact he is about a whole range of issues and how broad he's going to be and how many issues he's going to touch. America is a country that we need some investment. We need some work. He will talk about the rescue plan and how we were able to really get the COVID moving in the right direction. We came in with 8.6 million vaccines being distributed a week. Now we did 28 million last week. We vaccinated over 200,000 people in 92 days. So it will be with that seriousness of purpose that he delivers the speech tonight, and that we won't stop there. We also want to invest in our infrastructure. And when we mean infrastructure, we mean everything. We mean getting lead pipes that deliver water to homes. We want to get rid of them. We want to get rid of lead pipes that deliver water to schools and daycares. We want to remediate transportation infrastructure that split communities. We want to invest in education. And then if you look at the American Families Plan, he's going to talk about investing in families, and especially families that have been marginalized, to empower them to reach their destiny no matter where they start at. And so I think it's going to be an honest and open look at the country, where we are and where we should be. And so I think for many people, they will find it very honest and sobering. But at the same time, we're going to celebrate the fact that it's been an historic 100 days driven by purpose to get this country back on track. And we think we've done that in a number of ways.
Another issue that is in the news, white America is really now paying attention to this. Black America, we've been talking about this for a long time. We know this has been going on for 402 years. It's evolved to today. I'm talking about policing. This policing issue is front and center. I understand there was a lot of tears in the White House. You guys were watching the Chauvin trial, the verdict. What did you feel, and where were you? Were you with the president at the time?
I was, and he was surrounded by senior leaders and senior staff in the White House. We were in the process of meeting and talking about it when they announced that they were gonna read the verdict, and we were still together when the verdict was read. And I will tell you that I was with the president when we flew down to Houston, Texas to meet with the Floyd family. And in that room was Dr. Biden, Vice President, former Vice President Biden then, Reverend Sharpton, Ben Crump, and the family. And it was a very heartfelt conversation. It was a very moving conversation. And the president had to look at little Gianna, who lost her father through no fault of his own. He was killed by a police officer for just living his life.
And that murdered.
And that hit the president very hard. And so he continued communication with the family. And you saw when the verdict was handed down, he called Filonis to talk to him, inquired about Gianna, and reminded that she said that her daddy changed the world. And we have an obligation to make sure that that happens.
How old were you and where were you when this excessive force incident happened? And it is so crazy. Black people remember. You remember the moment. You remember what it smelled like, what it looked like, because you're in fear, and what it tasted like.
Yeah, look, I was, you know, unfortunately, I was at a party and, you know, I did a crazy thing, which means I broke up a fight. And both sides, because I knew both sides, I broke up a fight. Police officer ran up. I threw my hands up and I said, whoa, it's not what you think. And before I could finish, he hit me several times, knocked me to the ground. But fortunately, they had police officers around him that stopped him and pulled him off of me. And so, you know, the duty to intervene is real. And I'm glad that there were other officers there who saw how unnecessary it was. But, you know, at the time I was, I think I was a student at Morehouse at that time. And so, you know, it's something that we have to, we can't act like it doesn't happen. And the good thing now is it's all on tape. People can see it. But the frustration started with one that was on tape also. So if you go back to Rodney King, that was on tape and nothing happened. And so when you listen to NWA and their song, F the Police, it's not about saying, oh, we don't like the police, not at all. The song actually says this is NWA putting the Los Angeles Police Department on trial for police brutality. And they go through acts of police brutality. And that's what we've been dealing with since, you know, my age group, we've been dealing with it since the late 80s.
We've been dealing with it for 402 years, to be honest with you.
No, that's true. I'm just saying my age group.
And I know.
We've been calling it out. And so it's time. And it's part of that systemic racism that's always been around. And we're only talking about it in policing. But what I'm so excited about with this administration is that we're talking about systemic racism all over the board, whether it's housing discrimination, why African-Americans have, you know, significantly less wealth than their white counterparts. Part of it is because of home ownership and the inability to pass down wealth from one generation to the next. Some of it is access to capital. Some of it is it's all of those things. And so we as an administration have made a decision led by the president that we're gonna tackle every facet of systemic racism that we can while we're here.
I appreciate you. Do you have anything else you want to add?
No, look, I'm glad to see you at the Grio. I'm glad to see you doing well. You know, this may save some of your Instagram followers from your 200 posts a day, because for the last 30 minutes, you haven't been able to post. So, you know, we know where you are and what you're doing at all times.
Stop stalking my social media. But look,
I don't. It just pops up all the time.
But look, I want to say this. I so appreciate you. You have always shown up and shown out. I don't get a chance to talk too much, but when you come with stuff. And I appreciate you. And thank you for working for us. And thank you for being honest and only the way you know how.
Richmond out.
Peace.